Good morning, folks. Got some gorgeous plasma filament action over the limbs. Today we've got volcano concerns, new satellite imagery, and a concept that has been quietly chalking up wins on the scoreboard. We're starting at spaceweathernews.com. We're finding the last 24 hours on our star were very calm indeed. No flashes, pops, eruptions, or significant surface surges. The solar flaring remains bumpy down near the floor of the charts. Forecast is for that to continue as the large grouping exits the Earth-facing half and the incoming regions lack the activity. Solar wind here. Continued slow rise of the solar wind speed. We're inside the coronal hole stream now. We began taking minor geomagnetic instability last night, but it didn't materialize further. And we never did get the phi angle shift showing interplanetary field streaming sun to Earth. We retain that possibility this week, with the next coronal hole just becoming visible there at the left side. Let's go here to the weather. The snowstorm in the U.S. broke many records in many places, came close in others. Some places saw an entire winter expectation of snow in just one day. Let's go next to the longer-term climate. Last week, we showed how November was one of the coldest in the U.S. Well, here's the last 3 months. What's critical to notice is the minimal temperatures bottom left, maximum temperatures top right. The average, top left, is much more a function of the nighttime temps persisting, while the daily maximums, top right, are lower. This is the case when you look back over the whole year and into past years. The heat that they discuss in the news is all about what happens at night, not super scary daytime highs. We're coming quickly to Turrialba, third active volcano in the tropical Americas the last few days, more aesthetic of an eruption there. But news is coming out of Tanzania about the only volcano in the world that produces black, super-thin lava, less viscous than water, and moves faster than humans can run. The last great eruption was a decade ago, but in 2013 they found the magma reserve growing once again. This is much less of an aesthetic treat. Folks, this is not far from the Suswell Rift. It is not far from the dome collapse beneath Madagascar, which sent seismic waves around the world, and there are not many places on Earth that have a less bright outlook than southeastern Africa. Up next is PACE, the new biosphere satellite demonstrating its full globe mapping in 48 hours. PACE will be used to monitor everything from chemistry to cloud albedo and derive meaningful data about how the overall biosphere changes over time within those parameters. And last but not least, conformal gravity. Had to take a few days and make sure I was reading this all correctly. So unlike MOND or modified gravity, this concept does follow relativity and the many studies that indicate it. It does do away with dark matter. It is in harmony with known problematic gravitational issues in cosmology. It demands dark energy be an actual energy field and not a magic property of space-time. But the problem is its similarity with relativity. Everything positive also hints at the standard relativity models, so singled-out observations for it are lacking. But is that really true? A number of stories the last year do hint at its merit over dark matter. Not only can it be quantized unlike relativity, but that energy field they discuss would be the attractor of the widespread nanodust they've found. They continue finding covert normal matter and can't find any wimps. And galactic rotation itself, this is where conformal gravity makes the most sense. You don't have to change the model based on what you see. That's how they built it to begin with. We've got your wind maps, followed by shots of our star to close. We'll do this all again tomorrow, right here, but right now it's 4:25 a.m. in the new Valley of the Sun. Eyes open, no fear. Be safe, everyone.